car modifier Collective Carmageddon cuts Fiat Panda in half and turns it into the world's lowest car that still functions, steers, rides, and drifts like an ordinary, street-legal vehicle. At first glance, the dubbed world's lowest car appears floating on cemented roads. In reality, someone is driving it from the inside, their body bent and laying sideways, depending on their height and size, and as they control what seems to be a steering wheel straight from arcade machines. With reflective solar wings, this solar electric and hydrogen hybrid vessel is set to be the world's first 3D printed superyacht that will produce zero emissions and function with an infinite range. Pegasus Superyacht boasts a 3D printed mesh framework, enabling its extremely robust yet delicate form. The unique exterior design starts with a low, linear hull with a plum bow and silver metallic finish which blends and camouflages with the water's colors and motions. This foundation at the waterline supports the superstructure with multi-tiered, ephemeral glass wings that reflect the clouds in the sky. Ultimately in operation, Pegasus Superyacht will produce zero carbon emissions and will boast a virtually unlimited range. Works of great artists can now be replicated and potentially replaced using a robot chisel in Italy driven by self-programming software. Named Robotor, the automated chisel carves its way into the new era of sculpting. Users can feed data into a robot that can produce magnificent and thoroughly detailed marble and stone sculptures. Better yet, the robot itself can just work on its own. Robotor can weather heavy loads even in the most hostile environments, since its hardware and build have been designed to brave through flying marble shards and bulldozing extra sturdy materials. Self-programming the robot for its speed, effort, and power of milling can occur in real time through the installed technology. The software installed in the robot chisel, called AuReus, plays a major role in the creation of artist-made-like sculptures as it simplifies the production of complex sculptures as much as possible in less time. Transpod. The Canadian startup, building the world's leading ultra-high-speed ground transportation system, the Transpod line, has just unveiled FluxJet, an industry-defining innovation that will transform the way passengers and cargo are moved. Based on groundbreaking advances in propulsion and fossil fuel-free energy systems, the fully electric vehicle is designed as a hybrid between aircraft and train. It features technological leaps in contactless power transmission and a new field of physics called valence flux, enabling it to travel in a protected guideway at over 1,000 kilometers per hour, faster than a jet and thrice as fast as a high-speed train. According to the startup, this project will create up to 140,000 jobs and add $19.2 billion to the region's GDP throughout construction. In addition, once the Transpod line is in operation, it will cost passengers approximately 44% less than a plane ticket to travel the corridor and help reduce CO2 emissions by 636,000 tons per year. Greentech startup Levante draws inspiration from Japanese paper folding and designs foldable origami solar panels that can be easily brought and transported anywhere for off-grid charging and powering up. Levante origami solar panels are lightweight, enough to carry due to the sheerness of the solar plates, and can be easily installed in under a minute with their push and pull style. The hinges immediately fold and unfold to make it easier for the users to use them whenever they want to. Levante's foldable origami solar panels can also be used on different occasions, anywhere the users need renewable energy, and may be best as a traveling companion to those who want to sail away on water vehicles or try their hands at nomadic living with their camper vans. Foldable origami solar panels are made in Italy and comprise monocrystalline silicon cells that have 23.4% conversion efficiency. When the solar panels are open and sit in the sun all day, they can generate energy for the appliances in the camper van or boat with an estimate of 38 hours for a fridge, 27 hours for a laptop, 4 hours for an air conditioner, and an hour and a half for an induction stove. These solar panels, made from plant waste, can produce energy without direct sunlight. unlike traditional solar panels, which only work in clear conditions and must face the sun directly because they rely on visible light. The translucent AuReus material is able to harvest power from invisible UV rays that pass through clouds. The AuReus solar panel can produce energy nearly 50% of the time compared to the 15 to 22% of standard solar panels. The AuReus solar panels can be applied to windows or facades as a fluorescent covering. This strategy would transform any building into a performative generator or vertical solar farm, capturing UV rays, which bounce off of pavements and the surrounding buildings, thus maximizing the amount of energy generated. The Japanese are never short of ideas when it comes to innovation. After unveiling the first prototype this spring, the University of Tokyo is now presenting a new version of its Poimo concept, an inflatable electric scooter. The aim is to create an easily transportable device for use as and when needed. Poimo's new launch not only includes the electric scooter, but also a manual wheelchair type, light and soft, deflated and foldable. Poimo opens up new fields in terms of personal mobility. The unique characteristic of this project is that it takes advantage of being custom-made for each individual and contributes to the realization of an inclusive society where everyone can acquire the means of transportation that suits them. Even if you are not an expert, you can easily design personal mobility that suits each user's physique and riding style by simply shooting a pose that imagines the vehicle you want to use using dedicated software. Rightly named Jet Shark, the shark-shaped submersible comes through as the revamped version of the Watercraft Seabreacher, a two-seater personal watercraft that takes the form of a shark, killer whale, and even a dolphin. Just like its name, the design of the submersible resembles a tech and an engine-driven shark that can be manned by a pilot. Four passengers, pilot included, can enjoy the adrenaline rush Jet Shark offers as the spacious, air-conditioned cockpit seats them all comfortably with the leather-looking cushioned seating. Jet Shark floats well, and its design prevents the watercraft from completely sinking. Its small fins on the side help the vehicle from being stuck in a flipped position and roll it over so it goes back to its original riding position. The snorkel-looking airfoil above Jet Shark enjoys the view of the landscape, while the watercraft is sunk below through the installed camera at the center of it. It allows the pilot to see what is happening on the surface, preventing any accidents such as crashing into another watercraft or a swimmer. The ocean is our largest energy sink, and thus it will be central to solving the crisis of our generation. Because of the usual high costs associated with underwater vehicles, researchers have long relied on sonar to paint a map of the nebulous seafloor. American company Bedrock has unveiled an autonomous underwater vehicle AUV that aims to accelerate the ocean mapping process, support the offshore wind industry, and generally broaden our limited knowledge of ocean depths. Together with the new fully electric submarine, Bedrock is also launching an ocean mapping cloud platform called Mosaic. This technology lets customers manage the marine data recovered during deep sea explorations. In total, the world's oceans make up 361 million square kilometers, and as of 2022, Bedrock was able to map 34 million, or about 9% according to its public benefit report. Humanity needs a thorough seafloor map to ensure we can live on this planet for generations to come, and current maps don't cut it. The engineered Beachtech Sweepy Hydro, with its hydrostatic drive, is ideal for cleaning and leveling small beaches, volleyball courts, and other sandy areas. The hydrostatic concept makes it easy to operate and provides optimum maneuverability for easy access beneath sunshades and between deck chairs. With a wide range of accessory equipment, the range of operation for this compact machine extends way beyond the beach. The two shaking screens, working in opposing action, minimizes the vibration, while maximizing a thorough cleaning even when the sand is wet. The machine can rotate up to 360 degrees on its axis and has a backup. The machine guarantees a professional beach cleaning, even in difficult conditions, thanks to its low point of gravity and a strong and robust design.